time to time, I come across people where we get into a discussion as to what is the proper official language of Jews in today's society. We have a choice of some people who are older generation speak Yiddish. Some of the others who are born here speak Hebrew, speak English. And then those who live in Israel speak Hebrew. So the question I ask myself, which is the proper language? All three, two, one.
When you say proper language, what a Jew should speak?
Yeah.
Well, there's different ways of looking at the answer to that question. If we want to be able to communicate with one another, so we have to use the language that people understand. No matter what country we're in, if you're in America, we use English. If you're in Spain, you speak Spanish in order to communicate with each other. So we want to be able to communicate. So we have to talk the language of the land that people understand. When it comes to prayer and study of Torah, so then we're involved in holy kind of language, holy kind of activity. So then we use the holy tongue. We talk, pray to God in Hebrew, in the Mashon Kodesh, in the holy language, we call it. Even though we're allowed to pray in any language, the God is very multilingual. He can understand any language. Some people who cannot read Hebrew can't pray in Hebrew. They can pray in any language. But the mitzvah is l'chatchila. It's preferred that we pray in the Lashon Kodesh, we call Hebrew, because that is the language of the Torah, and it's a holy language. And if we really study the Talmud and Kabbalistic ideas, we see that every letter of the Aleph Beit has very, very deep meanings to it. Every letter, the way it's written, the way it's pronounced. You take, for instance, the letter. I'll take the Aleph, for instance, to give an example. The Aleph is an Aleph, but if you know how a sofer, a scribe, writes an Aleph, an Aleph is made from a Vav. The long line in the Aleph is a Vav, and the top is a Yud. It's called the Rosh, and the Regel, the foot, is a Yud. So the numerical value of an Aleph is 10, 10, and 6. That's Havaya. 26, the Shem Hashem, the Shem of Yud Kei Vav Kei, Hashem's name, main name of Hashem, that lies in the Aleph, because the Vav and the Yud and the Yud. So right away, in the beginning of the alphabet, we see this holiness is special. It's not just like ABC, just a letter of lines in order just to identify what we're trying to read, but every letter is special holiness to it and special depth to it. So, and the way we say it, and the words put together. So the holy language is what we use when we pray to Hashem. So that's another language. So communicating, we communicate with the language we understand. Praying to Hashem, we pray with language that's the holy language. According to some of the holy writings, Jewish people, when they were in Golus, they didn't want to assimilate, and they did different ways of keeping their identity as Jewish people. In Egypt, the Jewish people didn't change their language, didn't change the way of dress, didn't change their names. And Jewish people are out to the Golus, diaspora, in different countries, kept a special language. And the Ashkenazic people have the Yiddish that's based a lot on German, but really if you speak Yiddish, a German wouldn't understand it too good. And they want to have their own language in order to be aloof and separate from the rest of the community that they live in, to keep the Judaism and their identity. Because five of them have their own language, their Yiddish that they call. What's it called again?
It's
Ladino, right? So they kept their. So the Jews, wherever they went, they spoke the language. Most of them spoke the language of the country to communicate with their non-Jewish neighbors. But between themselves, they wanted to keep the identity. So here in America, we have a language called Yeshivish. Yeshivish is based on English, but it has so many Aramaic Gemara terminology, and so Hebrew terminology, If you ever spoke to a non-Jew, they wouldn't know what you're talking about. He said, when pshat is like this, he told him, oh, shteitzach, besvetzte. I mean, all these different lashonos we talk about from the Gemara, Kal v'chomer, shteitzach. So we have a mixture of, so we have our Yiddish today, is the yeshivish we call, based on, so Yiddish is based on German, but it's mixed with other languages. And yeshivish is based on English, but it has so many different terminology. So we have the three different ways of languages we're talking about. The one we communicate with our non-Jewish neighbors, and the one that we pray to Hashem with, and the one that we use between ourselves in order to keep our identity.
Thank you very much.
Who can I call?